such as the English courts, where the GB boxing team train and use the facilities, as well as Jessica Ennis, and working alongside these elite athletes is really inspiring and it's really made me want to further my career in sports. Being a student at the university has given me a lot of voluntary experience, for example, coaching within schools, coaching for school sports partnerships, county sports partnerships, working at the National Disability Championships, and hopefully next to work at the Winter Olympics in Russia.
WWE, yep. Now securing this victory over Alberto Del Rio, moving forward in this number one contendership tournament. Yeah. How do you feel now moving forward?
I feel awesome. I mean, what do you think I wanted to move backward?
Of course not.
I didn't even have my mind set on this Intercontinental tournament, really. I just wanted to come back, you know, and it happens to be that what I bring to the table qualified me. And now, like you said, boom. Got one down. I can't even think about who's next on the bracket. I just got to think about being myself, RVD. And wherever that gets me, the top, I'll just be satisfied when I get there.
Awesome. Well, looking forward to watching you climb the ranks again.
Right. And then who are we going to see at the top?
RVD.
You got it.
Yeah.
Got it.
Bam. RVD, everybody.
I'm intrigued and amazed.
No way. No way!
Did he get his own?
Yes way!
Oh my God!
Neutralizer to the 400-pound plus Henry. Cesaro advances.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of the match and the newest Paul Heyman guy, the King of Swing, Cesaro!
Cesaro, Paul Heyman, a very impressive victory out there tonight with the neutralizer. But looking forward to next week and moving forward in this championship tournament for the number one contendership to the Intercontinental.
It's amazing. Why you acted as if it's a surprise that Cesaro can just easily beat Mark Henry. Why are you still surprised?
Mark Henry's a very large and worthy opponent.
Yeah, and? We don't put him against slugs, do we?
No, of course not.
Was The Undertaker a slug? Would it have mattered to WrestleMania who was in the ring with Brock Lesnar? No. It could have been John Cena, same result. Could have been Daniel Bryan, same result. Could have been Bruno Sammartino, Hulk Hogan, Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Rock. It doesn't matter. It just so happened to be The Undertaker, the one victory no man in life could ever have. But Brock Lesnar can get that victory the same way. It doesn't matter who Cesaro's opponent is next week. I haven't even bothered. I'm not going to lower myself, Renee, to look at the brackets and find out who is the next victim for Cesaro. Who is the next person? Who is the next rung on the ladder as Cesaro climbs up to the top tier in WWE?
But Mr. Heyman, you're not at all curious as far as preparation for Cesaro moving forward in the championship tournament at all?
You're so cute when you get aggravated. Do you know that? Go ahead. Surprise me, Renee. Tell me who it is. Who Cesaro have to face next week?
Rob Van Dam.
All right. All right.
Yeah.
Sounds good to me.
We have to talk.